In this lecture, I am going to talk about the matched filter at pass band. Now, when I say pass band, matched filters, I am essentially referring to the situation when our input pulse may not be a baseband pulse. The input is a pass band pulse. So when I say pass band pulse, I am essentially referring to the fact that it is embedded onto a carrier. And here, I would like to appreciate both mathematically as well as physically how these quantities can be specified and what will look like. Okay, so physically what we mean by passband pulse and how does it look like. So these are the two things we are going to look at in this section. So a typical passband pulse can be given by S tilde of t. Let me choose the maybe red color. S tilde of t given by SR of t modulates the cos of 2 pi f naught t, and here the imaginary component is modulated by sin 2 pi f naught t. So this is my passband pulse. When I say passband pulse, the noise also will be in the passband. So the received noise will be given by n tilde of t, that also given by nr of t times cos of 2 pi f naught t, and ni of t times sin of 2 pi f naught t. This ni of t indicates quadrature phase component. Quadrature phase component, and this is in phase component of the noise. In phase component. Okay, and the real part also you can call this is a real part. Therefore, the real part modulating the cos of 2 pi f naught t cosine carrier, as well as this is called imaginary part. The imaginary part modulating a sinusoidal carrier at frequency f naught. Both are at frequency f naught. Cosinusoidal and sinusoidal both are at a frequency f naught. So now, what can you say about that the matched filter? Because the input is passband pulse. So input is passband. Therefore, you should use passband matched filters. Passband matched filter. Now we already seen baseband matched filters. In the baseband matched filter, if the input is S of t, then the filter is matched to S conjugate of minus t if you sample at t equal to 0, right? So similarly, if the pulse is S tilde of t, and then this is going to be S tilde conjugate of minus t if you sample at t equal to 0. In general case, the input, maybe I'll draw here. Input is S tilde of t, and this is given to the passband matched filter. The response is the general matched filter response or impulse response is given by t0 minus t. So this is the passband matched filter impulse response. Now we put tilde because we are talking on passband. Therefore, your S tilde of complex conjugate of let us assume t not equal to 0 in this case to make our life simple, minus t. And take this equation, S tilde of t is given here. Okay, so this is given by S R of minus t. You replace t by minus t, cosine of 2 pi f naught minus t, right? Plus the imaginary component. The imaginary component is it's a passband pulse, right? So minus S I of t, right? Times this is minus here, minus, let me erase this, minus t sine of 2 pi f naught minus t. Okay, now this becomes the whole thing. You take complex conjugate, and this whole thing is a real pulse, right? If you take complex conjugate, nothing will happen, the same thing will get data. Therefore, this is going to be SR of minus t. Anyway, cos is a even function, so you will get as it is cos of 2 pi f naught t minus, again this is real, so SI of minus t, and this sine is a even odd function, so this minus becomes plus sine of 2 pi f naught. This is the matched filter impulse response at pass band, S tilde of minus t. Okay, so this is the corresponding matched filter at the pass band. Impulse response of the matched filter, impulse response of the matched filter. Okay, and here there is a minus note down. Okay, so you can as well alternately think of the signal S of T as a complex envelope, because you can write the passband pulse in terms of a baseband pulse. So that baseband pulse is given by S of T. This S of T equal to the real part S R of T plus J times S sub I of T. This is the complex baseband representation. Okay, so this is the complex signal in the baseband. When I say baseband, the signal is not modulated by the carrier. When I say passband, it is embedded onto a carrier. That's the only difference. Now, how do you, this is no pulse, and for this pulse, how do you find the response, impulse response G of T for a matched filter? Then this should be like a S conjugate of minus T, right? So then take conjugate of this. So S conjugate of minus T. So replace T by minus T in the right hand side. So S R of minus T plus J times S sub I of minus T and the whole conjugate. So this is going to be S R. And again, if you bring this conjugate here, nothing will happen because it's a real pulse. So you can write S R of minus T. But this J becomes minus, minus J times S sub I of minus T. If you want, you can put complex conjugate here also. And again, since it is a real pulse, S R of minus T minus J times S sub I of minus T. This is a response of your filter for complex baseband input signal. Okay, so what is this? This is the impulse response of the matched filter when the input is complex baseband. So this is a mathematical description of the passband matched filter, both in the passband notation as well as in the baseband notation. This is the response at baseband, and where is it? Yeah, this is a response at the passband. It's a mathematical representation. Fine. Now, let me explain this pictorially. So I have depicted the situation as follows. For the case of imaginary part is zero, because I want to make the life little simple. So instead of taking the imaginary part also, let us assume this S sub I of T equal to zero. In this case, we are considering a passband pulse with only cosinusoidal carrier to which the baseband pulse may be modulating. Obviously, the corresponding matched filter will be simply this. So in this case, S tilde of T is equal to S sub R of T times cosine of 2 pi f naught t, because the real part is that is 0, leave it up. So what is this is my input, passband input. What is the impulse response in this case, simplified case? Impulse response, it's simply you take S tilde of t and replace by minus t. So this is going to be S sub R of minus T cosine of 2 pi F naught replace T by minus T, right? So then this is S conjugate of minus T tilde, which is equal to S sub R of minus T times cosine of 2 pi F naught T. Therefore, the input is S R of T times cosine of 2 pi f naught t given to the matched filter. The matched filter is matched to the input signal, so minus t times cos of 2 pi f naught t. And what is the output for this? This two signal will convolve with each other. Therefore, the output is S R of t times cosine of 2 pi f naught t convolution with the impulse response S R of minus T times cosine of 2 pi f naught t. Look at here and here. So both are cos of 2 pi f naught, you can take it out in the convolution. It's a linear operation. Therefore, SR of t convolution with SR of minus t times cos of 2 pi f naught. This is the output of the matched filter. Okay, here S of t is real. Yes, a bar of t is real, and the whole thing, this whole thing is real. Okay, so even the input also real. Input is completely real, therefore the output will be completely real. So I am just calling the input signal as a some baseband pulse times cos of 2 pi f naught. Say this is a baseband pulse is modulated by some carrier. So when you do the modulation with baseband pulses, then that is called a passband pulse. Therefore, the matched filter corresponding to that input will have an impulse response, this S sub minus R of t and cos of 2 pi f naught t. And the output is, we are getting this one, S sub R of t convolved with S sub R minus t times cos of 2 pi f naught t. And again, the output also a passband pulse whose envelope will now look like this. So what is the envelope? This is the envelope of the output pulse or output. Envelope of the output. So it is a convolution between the input baseband pulse and the baseband pulse of the matched filter. See, this is the input. Let me choose different color. See, this one is the input. Input baseband pulse. And there's a baseband of the filter. Baseband pulse of the filter. Okay, therefore the envelope is convolution of your input baseband pulse and baseband pulse of the filter. So input is a passband signal. So obviously the filter also should be passband, and now the filter is integrated. It's a low pass filter in general, but here it is a passband filter, and the filter is tuned to frequency f naught. Okay, and it has a passband around f naught, and the output will also be a passband pulse. So the input is by a passband, the filter is a passband, and the output will also be a passband pulse. Okay, whose output will be given by this S conjugate, SR t conjugate SR of minus t times cos of 2 pi f naught t. So let me depict this. So how it looks, you take a passband pulse like this, passband pulse, and this the output is, it's a convolution of this pulse, and again time reversed version of the same pulse, and do the convolution. So once you do the convolution, it looks like this, like a triangular shape. Okay, your pulse look like this. So this is the output of your matched filter, passband matched filter output. Passband matched filter. So your input is a rectangular pulse like this, and this pulse is denoted by S of t, and it is modulated by cos of 2 pi f naught t. So you'll get a gated sinusoidal pulse or cosinusoidal pulses. This is the gated cosinusoidal pulse. So this is your input. Okay, and the output will be a triangular pulse like this, but the triangular pulse is modulated by the carrier. Recall from your signals and systems, if you have a pulse like this and you convolve with another pulse like this, then you'll get a triangular pulse like this. So let's say this is 0 to t and this also 0 to t, and the total duration is the sum of these two durations. So the duration is t here, and here also the duration is t. So therefore t plus t equal to 2t, that is the total width of the pulse. Therefore the convolved pulse width equal to 2t, and the peak occurs at small t equal to capital T. So this is a peak point occurs at this point, right? So it is you can say this is autocorrelation function, and autocorrelation peaks at the middle of the output of the autocorrelator. So therefore the total duration is 0 to t, and the peak occurs at t equal to capital T. The duration is 2t. total duration, right? So this is a baseband pulse, and okay, like a baseband, a rectangular pulse. And what should have been the matched filter output? It should be a triangular pulse like this. So it is autocorrelation function of the input signal. See, this is my input signal, and this is a filter, yeah, response, filter impulse response. Okay, so you'll get a triangular pulse, and the peak coming at a capital T. So the same thing when you are doing in the passband here. So the pulse is passband pulse, and you are getting passband pulse, but the shape is triangular now, and the maximum occurs at this location. So let me redraw the figure again. So you have your passband pulse like this, let's say 0 to T, and the output of the matched filter is like this, and you have the pulse like this, and the whole duration is 0 to T, and the peak occurs at capital T. Now the peak value is determined by the signal amplitude. Let us assume there is no noise. In such a case, what will happen? The peak value is completely depend on the signal amplitude. In case if the signal is contaminated by noise, then there is a variation in the peak value. Okay, so if there is no noise, then you will get a no peak value what you want. That peak value is determined completely by the signal amplitude, input signal amplitude. Let's say this is A. If noise is added with the signal, then the peak value is completely changed. How much it varies, that depends on the variance of the input signal. Okay, and the second method is we can as well implement this passband matched filter at baseband itself. Okay, so that let me draw here. You take a passband pulse. So 1 minute, a baseband matched filter for a passband pulse. See, in the previous case we have taken input is passband pulse and a matched filter also a passband pulse. But now what we are going to say is you take a passband pulse, S of let's say S sub R of T times cosine of 2 pi F naught T. Okay, but the passband pulse is down converted to a baseband pulse. How do? You just do by frequency translating. Okay, down translating. So multiply by cos of 2 pi F naught and give it to a matched filter, and this matched filter is S sub R of minus T. Okay, and then once you get the output, then again you up convert this one. You multiply by cos of 2 pi f naught, and the output is, see here you will get a what will you get? Let's say point A. At point A, I will get a S sub R of T times cos of 2 pi f naught T times cos of 2 pi f naught T. Then this is equal to S sub R of T times cos square 2 pi F naught T. Then I can write this using trigonometric identity as 1 plus cos of 4, this is 2 here, 4 pi F naught T whole divided by 2. Then S sub R of T by 2 plus S sub R of T times cos of 4 pi F naught T whole divided by 2. So this is what you are giving here, and this is a low pass filter. I already discussed this. So low pass filter completely removes this guy. So let's say this is point B. At point B, what you get? Point B, what you get is the input S sub R of T by 2 convolved with the S sub R of minus T. For the time moment, let us forget this scaling factor. Okay. So therefore, at point B, you'll get a S sub R of T convolved with a S sub R minus T. So this point is S sub R of t convolved with S sub R of minus t, and the whole thing is multiplied by C. So at point C, you'll get a S sub R of t convolved with S sub R minus t and multiply by cos of 2 pi f naught. So this is what you'll get. Therefore, finally the same output we are getting here. See, this, let me call capital I. Look at here also, the same output here also you'll get it. See, S sub R of t, then S sub minus R of t and cos of 2 pi f naught. The only thing is your input is passband. Then you are down translating to baseband, and then do the matched filtering, and then you come over to up translating. Okay, taking it back to again to the record frequency, f naught or f naught one or whatever it is. So whether this type of record or not will depend on the application. And the component 2 f naught will be here. This is here the frequency component is 2 times f naught. This 2 times f naught will be removed by the low pass filter, your matched filter. Removed by the baseband matched filter. Okay. Now the whole operation. I copied a figure from the textbook. I'll show you. Yeah, you can look at here. See, the input is a passband pulse, and the filter also a passband filter, a passband matched filter for a passband pulse. And the output is given like this. These two are convolved here, and out multiplied by cos of 2 pi f naught. The same operation can be done in the baseband matched filter. Okay, so the input is passband filter, you multiply by cos of 2 pi f naught, so you down translating to baseband, and 2 times frequency, because once you multiply cos 2 pi f naught, you have 2 f naught frequency, not f naught. Here the frequency component is f naught, and here also the frequency component is f naught, carrier frequency, but here at this point the frequency is 2 f naught. That will be removed by your matched filter, removed by low pass, baseband matched filter. And again you do the up conversion, and then finally you are ending with this output. So either way you can do this operation. Now a concise expression for the complex baseband input, complex baseband signal output R of t of complex baseband matched filter G of t uses the abbreviation of the convolution. It is given as follows. Like the input I can say in the baseband as S sub R of t plus, let's say this is a filter, okay? So yeah, let me write this input pulse, okay? J times S sub I of t. Now what is my G of t? G of t equal to S conjugate of minus t. Therefore G of t is equal to S sub R of t minus J times S sub I of t. What is this? This is the input complex baseband signal. And what is this one? This one is the impulse response of the matched filter. For complex baseband signal. Now what is R of t? Suppose you have the filter like this, and input is your baseband pulse S of t, and this is your G of t, and let's say this is my R of t. What is R of t? R of t is given by S of t, the input, and convolved with G of t. Right, so you can write this one. So in the R of t I can represent again R sub real part capital R of t plus J times R sub I of t. In the right side you can substitute the value. What is S of t? S sub R of t plus J times S sub I of t convolved with the convolution operation, you will get S sub R of t minus j times S sub I of t. You multiply now term by term. So this is going to be, let me write down the final answer here. S sub R of t convolved with the S sub R of t, the first term. Sorry, here minus actually, I'm sorry, here this is minus. Here also minus, I'm sorry, I did not mention here. Let me write down properly. Yes, S sub R minus t minus j times S sub I of minus t, your impulse response. So therefore, here also wrong. It is minus t minus j times S sub I of minus t. Okay, so this guy is going to be minus t. This is the first term. Then this term times this term, and then minus. Let me write down the terms, and then I can separate out. S sub R of t times S sub I of minus t second term, and you multiply this guy, plus j times S sub I of t times S sub R of minus t, and then take this guy here. J times j minus, and minus into minus it is plus. So S sub I of t times S sub I of minus t. Okay, there are four terms now. So separate out our real part and the imaginary part. So S sub R of t, it's a convolution operation, and here also convolution operation, and here also convolution operation, and S sub R of minus t, right? So this is the first term, plus S sub I of t convolved with S sub I of minus t. Let me put like this. Let me remove this braces here. Okay, then you put a plus j terms here. S sub I of t convolved with the S sub R of minus t minus S sub R of t convolved with the S sub I of minus t. Okay, so this is the real part and this is the imaginary part. Now look at this real part and the imaginary part. This real part I can say R sub R of t, and this one I can represent R sub I of t, imaginary part of the output. Now when I sample this waveform at t equal to 0, then what will happen? These two are no orthogonal. Okay, cross correlation. So that will be 0. So if you notice that a purely real pulse has a purely real matched filter output, and purely imaginary pulse also has a purely real matched filter output. Okay, so if you take purely real pulse, and the matched filter output also a purely real. Okay, and if you take a purely imaginary pulse, and the output also has a purely real matched filter output. And what happens, the imaginary component at the output of the matched filter is, it is produced by the cross convolution terms between the real and imaginary components at the input. So this is a real part, and this is a real part of the input, and this is the imaginary part of the input. Is a cross convolution terms between the real and imaginary components at the input. Furthermore, if you look at properly, if you notice here, the imaginary component of the output is always 0 at t equal to 0. Okay, so when you sample at t equal to 0, then it is always 0, because one is imaginary and another one is real, because real function is even and imaginary function is odd. When I say t equal to 0, one function will be maximum and the other function will be minimum. Therefore, it is always equal to 0. So the imaginary component need not be computed if only the value at t equal to 0 is of interest. So whenever you want to calculate the output R at time t equal to 0, no need to bother about the imaginary part. Don't bother about the imaginary part. Imaginary part, because here this is real and this is imaginary compound. Okay, if one function is no even and another function is odd, let's say one function is even, let's say this is real, and the another one is symmetric like this goes, and when this is maximum this is zero, so therefore what happens, these two will get cancel each other, so the imaginary part is always zero at time t equal to zero if you do the cross convolution. So the cross convolution terms between the real and imaginary components at the real and imaginary components will be zero at t equal to zero. So at the sampling instant t equal to zero, the output will be the output R of zero is given by these two terms. Okay, yes, this one, the first two terms, this one, convolution of this one and convolution of this one. Okay, equals the and this is now given in terms of convolution integral. You can write R of zero, like R of t, you can say it's a convolution operation after all, so let me write down properly. R of t is equal to convolution of the two terms, where is it, sr of t and sr of minus t. Sr of t convolved with s sub r of minus t, and then the second term is plus s sub I of t convolved with s sub I of minus t. Okay, so if you replace this convolution operation by convolution integral, then s sub r of tau times s sub r of t minus tau, then this is s sub I of tau times convolved with s sub I of t minus tau, and the whole thing is multiplied by d tau. This is my r of t. Now we assume that t equal to 0 sampling instant. At sampling instant t equal to 0, the imaginary component can be neglected. That's why we end up with only real components, real part of output. So therefore r of 0 equal to integral of, by the way, this is complex conjugate and this also complex conjugate, s sub r of tau times s sub r of minus tau, it's conjugate, complex conjugate, then s sub I of tau times s sub I of conjugate of minus tau, the whole thing is multiply by d tau, integrate, then this is, this one is mod of, I can say s sub r of tau mod square times plus s sub I of tau mod square times d tau, and if you, what is this, this is the energy of s sub r of t, and this is the energy of s sub I of t. Okay, therefore the output equals the pulse energy, which is always real. So again, this quantity is going to be real. If you do the integration, you will get a real value. Therefore the complex signals with which we deal are contaminated by complex noise. Okay, this is noise with both the real part and imaginary part, and rather than deal with the total noise power, we prefer to deal with the noise power per component of the complex noise. With this convolution, signal to noise analysis of real waveforms and of complex waveforms share the same formulas, whether you take complex waveforms or real waveforms, the signal to noise ratio formula will be the same. Okay, and this is the just an introduction to passband matched filters. So we started with the passband pulse. When I say passband pulse, the baseband pulse is modulated by the carrier, so that is called a passband pulse. So whenever you have passband pulse, then passband pulse should be given to the passband matched filter, and of course output also a passband filter, passband output pulse also passband pulse. The same passband matched filter can be realized using baseband matched filter, and that also we discussed. You first down translate to baseband, by multiplying the cos of 2 pi f naught in, that is the carrier, and then give to the baseband matched filter, and that filter will remove the 2f frequency component. It is shown here. Where is it? Yeah, here this one removes the 2f frequency component. Let me show here. Yeah, so it removes 2f frequency component, and again can do the convolution, and again up to do the up conversion, and finally will end up with this result. So this is a slight introduction to the passband matched filters. So let me stop at this point. In the next lecture we will enter into demodulation of your binary modulation schemes. Various binary modulation schemes we have discussed, so that we will start in the next class. We will start with binary antipodal signals, and then binary orthogonal signals, and then later on we'll move on to performance analysis of binary signals, okay, binary modulated waveforms or binary digital modulation schemes. Okay, so let me stop at this point.